In today's episode of MB Yachting, we'll take a look at the sailboat Ilan 450. We'll walk you through the marina at Portorož, Slovenia. And finally, you'll learn about the catamaran Lagoon 620.
Sailboats also fall into the category of luxury products. Today we have a treat for you called Ilan 450, whose graceful looks and sophisticated design rank her among the top of this segment. This beautiful boat is 45 feet long, heading into the cruiser racer category, and it is a model from 2009, designed by the court designer of Ilan, Rob Humphrey. The crew can enjoy a sporty ride as well as plenty of comfort for several days at sea.
Let's now take a look at what the boat offers on the inside. The use of wood and straight lines visually expands the interior space. You can choose from two variations of interior layout with three or four cabins. The three cabin version features a spacious captain's cabin with a lot of storage space. In the four cabin version, the front cabin has been reduced to the minimum, which makes room for another single cabin, also minimalistic. The other two cabins are traditionally placed at the rear. An elegant lounge will offer you plenty of space and many practical details with conservative and time-tested design. The designers didn't try to use every inch of space for furniture and left a lot of floor space, which enhances the airy feel. The quality of design and material used to build this ship are common for boats with a much higher price.
The ship's cockpit is relatively shallow, suitable for its sporty nature. All controls are easily accessible, and the crew can move around the deck without undue restraint. The deck looks just as elegant as the ship's interior. There's a hidden table in the cockpit floor, which you can simply lift, and within a few seconds, the ship will turn from a racing pier into a place where you can chat with friends on holiday.
The design of Ilan 450 will let you know that its makers were inspired by the racing specials of the Class Open 6. The double helm isn't just a purposeless fancy. It allows wider hull design in the rear for better performance. The riding experience is different than with most cruisers of this length due to the wide hull and asymmetrical spinnaker. This sailboat, suitable for a captain with racing experience, one who wants to enjoy a fast and fun ride, even with an incomplete crew. An asymmetrical spinnaker is much easier to control than a symmetrical one, and you need fewer hands to maneuver it. The 450 can make effective use of even light breeze, but a crew of three is able to control it in a strong wind as well. All in all, Ilan scores with good workmanship and elegant design. The crew will enjoy the kind of comfort which is standard for sailboats of this size, and if treated properly, it will reward them with a fast riding experience and a feeling which never becomes ordinary.
Thank you.
let's stay at the sea for a little longer. If you decide to buy a sailboat or a yacht, you have to know where your new pet worth a few million will anchor. In the Gulf of Trieste, on the Slovenian Adriatic coast, you'll find a beautiful place. The biggest and best equipped Slovenian seaside and climatic spa, the Port of Porto Rose. Porto Rose means the Port of Roses. The city life flows in a peaceful atmosphere of many cafes, shops, and taverns. The marina is in the center of the city, so if you want to go out in the evening, you can use the local transportation system.
The marina was established in 1974, and it offers more than 1,000 places for anchoring both at the sea and on the land. It's impressive in size and has a logical organization. The boats here are protected against the wind. Very favorable conditions for safe navigation and amateur sailing. The basic offer includes service facilities with professional staff who can speak English. For all the time we were shooting in the marina, the place looked very clean. Everything was in place.
Standard services include maintenance of the ship, specifically the hull, engine, sails, and so on. There are three self-propelled hoists for lifting and lowering ships, and there's also a special crane for masts with lifting capacity of up to 4,000 kilograms. For prices of mooring and other related services, visit the official website of Porto Rose Marina, but it is necessary to say that they fall into the category with higher prices.
If you decide to stay right in the Porto Rose Marina, get ready for scenery with fantastic views at yachts and spectacular sunsets. By the way, the residence is located just 5 minutes' walk from a sports center where you can play tennis, miniature golf, basketball, volleyball, and enjoy other sporting activities. You can try delicious culinary specialities in two restaurants where you can eat a la carte. The resort is an ideal holiday destination full of evergreen plants, and you can enjoy many musical and other cultural events. There are conference centers, casinos, and superb restaurants and bars where you can relax and taste Mediterranean delicacies. The Porto Rose Marina, definitely a very good choice for you and your ship.
Now, there's a time for a regular competition. We have the following question for you. Ben Ainslie is one of the world's most famous sailors. How many Olympic gold medals does he have? Send your answer to the email address on the screen. The winners will receive prizes from Gostra, which produces apparel not only for sailors. This giant, made by Lagoon, marked 620, boasts the title of the largest catamaran with the Lagoon logo. The company, Van Petegem Lauriot Prevost, top naval architects, who have cooperated with Lagoon for a long time, also participated in the design. The main mission of this 20-meter-long catamaran is to provide the crew with plenty of luxury and comfort. But at the same time, they won't miss the fast riding experience. The sails cover an area the size of a tennis court, and they will swiftly move forward, even in this floating hotel.
With a catamaran such as Lagoon 620, you can set out on a journey around the world without losing the comfort of your home. Despite its size and splendor, the catamaran remains user-friendly, so there is no need for too many staff. You can sail away in a pair, but the ship can hold up to 14 people for a comfortable ride. The variable and spacious interior of the catamaran can be adapted to the needs of the crew. The advantage of 620 is two steering wheels on each side, which allows the helmsman sufficient view for manoeuvring.
But the best thing about this ship is the interior, which is a clear demonstration of the designer's style, where everything is dominated by space and comfort. The French company Lagoon offers the 620 in several versions with regard to individual customer requirements. There are either five or three double cabins, each with its own bathroom with a shower and a toilet. One of the most popular design features, a kitchen in the rear section with access to the lounge as well as onto the deck by special steps. Under the marquee, which is placed on the roof extension of the whole ship, there is a dining room for serving refreshment from a wet bar. Another advantage is a moving bridge in the rear section, which allows even more space for social events. One of the strengths of this ship is also its electronics, with a sophisticated audio system and a TV room.
According to the makers, Lagoon 620 is a symbol of French art of living, and it's in the same class as Sunreef 62 and Eleuthera 60. A big advantage of this Lagoon giant is its comfort, but the catamaran also provides many practical solutions. Everybody will appreciate easy access to water for swimming, and with its many rooms and spaces, it will give each crew member a chance to spend time as they wish, whether in company of others or in privacy. Moving around the ship is very easy because of the non-slip surfaces and the proper height of the steps. All these features make the 620 by Lagoon a very pleasant, versatile boat.
An icon of British sport. That's what you can call Ben Ainslie, who is not only an icon, but mainly one of the most talented yachtsmen of today. This Englishman has had an incredible career crowned by his famous Olympic achievements. He started sailing at the very young age of 4 years, and he took part in his first race at only 10. In 1993, he won his first gold medal at the World Championship in the laser radial class, and 2 years after that at the Junior World Sailing Championship. In the years 1998, 2002, and 2008, he became the ISAF Rolex Yachtsman of the Year. Kinsley competes mainly on small solo sailboats, and although as a member of various British teams he took part in America's Cup of Cabin Yachts, he's always happy to return to his royal discipline. That is illustrated by Ainslie's Olympic successes, for which he is famous around the world. He first won his Olympic medal in Atlanta in 1996, Although then it was just a silver, in 2000 in Sydney, he turned it into gold. Ainsley is right now in his prime and at home in London. In 2012, he will try to prove that the Olympic Games have never seen a better yachtsman.
Cape Horn. Name, life goal, horror for many sailors for almost 500 years. A maze of channels, straits, islands, and fjords. The stormiest sea in the world. And yet the secret dream of every sailor to at least once in his life get to these waters. Especially in times of old, sailboats which had minimal ability to sail against the wind, the voyage to the west was extremely difficult. The sea at 55 degrees south latitude lies in the area of the Howling 50s.
The name itself suggests a sound background to be found here most of the year. Gigantic anti-cyclone which dominates the South Pacific Ocean all year causes prevailing west winds, which unobstructed, which blow with exceptional intensity throughout the year. The waves produced in this single spot can run around the globe without stopping. This is the reason why, in Drake's Passage, where they get into the narrowest place and where depth shrinks under 100 meters, the waves run extremely high. They can be 8 to 10 meters high, especially with long periods of west winds.
The first person who probably sailed from the Atlantic to the Pacific on a small sailboat was the world-famous Joshua Slocum on his boat Spray, but he used the Strait of Magellan. The first one to sail around Cape Horn through Drake's Passage was a Danish man, Al Hansen, who unfortunately died soon afterwards in a shipwreck near the Chilean coast. There are only a few people today who are rich enough or are big enough dreamers who can afford to cast away concerns of their livelihood and set off on a really long voyage. Officially, a successful rounding of Cape Horn means starting anywhere north of the 50th southern parallel in one ocean and finishing north of the 50th parallel in the other one, while of course the journey from east to west is valued more. If you choose to sail here, you should pick the simpler way, which will be very respectable nonetheless. As a well-deserved reward, you can see beautiful natural sceneries full of fjords, icebergs, and local fauna. And finally, also earrings, which a real sailor can wear only after sailing around Cape Horn.
At the very end of today's episode of Mercedes-Benz Yachting, we have prepared a real treat. It is a motor yacht Azimut 64. Originality and sporty design are evident at first look. It is impressive to watch this majestic yacht slide on the water surface. Deck and roof lines radiate elegance and harmony, and large windows give the ship a more aggressive look. The safety of this yacht is certified with approvals in Class A, or in other words, you can sail on Azimut 64 in any sea, any weather.
The fuselage and other parts of the ship were designed to meet the highest requirements for safety and comfort using innovative composite materials. This ensured greater compactness, decreasing the body weight, achieving greater savings in fuel consumption.
The entrance door for the cabin crew is waterproof. The interior has been designed ergonomically so that it is comfortable enough for relaxation and gives the crew enough space to move around. The cockpit is spacious and functional, just like the lounge placed in the center of the ship, serving as a sort of junction. Azimut 64 sets a new benchmark in terms of organization and systematic comfort. Highly recommended.